Well, back home at Duck and Willow Creek, once a month in the old school, they... Now, mate, I'll excuse you when you sit down there. Go on, get it into gear and sit down before Uncle Chad breaks your bloody back. As I was about to say, back home at Duck and Willow Creek, once a month in the old school, they used to have a dance, and some of the people would come out from Howard, which is the nearest town. They'd bring some grog, and we used to really turn it on. Anyway, this is what used to happen at the Duck and Willow dance. Duck and Willow Creek was summoned for the dance that had been coming, was ready now, and we were set to go. Then two women started fighting, and I couldn't put in writing the words that they were flinging to and fro. Some men folk they were skiting, and the women wouldn't quieten. You should have heard the noise that they all made. One kitty, he was shouting and climbing up the spouting, and the rest of them were drinking lemonade. Then a fella in the crowd yelled, "Here comes a truck from Howard. It's the bomb, what's bringing out the grog?" Then we all made a rush, just like cattle from a crush, for the glass was hidden in a hollow log. And folk that boy did I make whoopee. People knew where I would be. Some of you may think that I'm a sap, but I didn't need a glass. I just sat down on the grass underneath the keg and then turned on the tap. When the beer was done, we started on the rum. When we drink out there, we do a proper job. I had another snort, then I chased a snazzy sort, but she turned around and slapped me in the gob. Now don't you folk get thinking all we do out there is drinking. We often have to make our own home brew. It'll knock you rotten, your tongue will feel like cotton, 'cause we make it out of the hops of a kangaroo.